6:38, time to check your forecast. A little grayer out there. It's keeping temperatures up, though, and also some rains to look live over York. Gray overcast skies for this morning. Here comes more rain. We had some go through overnight. Look at more showers moving in right along the turnpike, and then there's more where that came from back over the Ohio Valley, getting in a little closer. You can see some showers now moving out of Franklin into parts of Adams County. Get ready, Gettysburg. Some rain coming your way. Same thing up in Biglerville. You can see some of that light rain this morning. And occasionally we'll see some showers. Here's your forecast for today. It's going to be a rather cloudy day, although it may brighten along the Mason-Dixon line. Could even get it closer to 80 degrees there. Most of us will stay in the middle 70s for today. Then overnight tonight near 60, still not that chilly, but a northerly wind. And still a little bit of shower activity tonight. I don't expect it to rain a lot. And tomorrow, probably a little drier day than today, but still, there's at least that threat of a shower around, particularly in the afternoon. We get a little sunshine, though. It could dry it out a little bit. Lower 70s for tomorrow. Carlisle at 62 right now. Sealands Grove at 58 degrees. Some 50s up north. But remember, yesterday we had some 30s up north. Not a lot of 60s. South 63 in York and Reading also at 63. A lot of clouds over us. And we're getting those showers coming on through. But you see, we're not the only ones. That line of showers extends all the way back. In fact, all the way back into the Plain States out toward Denver. It's all along a frontal boundary, and that front's going to continue eastbound. The high pressure gave us a gorgeous couple of days. It's now moving away. We're still getting a southerly flow, so temperatures aren't all that cool. What will happen, I think, today, we'll be in and out of those showers. May get a little break overnight tonight, and then more showers will come in along the front, maybe overnight tonight, and a few around during the day tomorrow. What I'm banking on tomorrow is high pressure will just suppress the front enough to keep it mostly dry during the day tomorrow. I can't rule out a shower. But then another area of low pressure. We talked about this yesterday with more moisture out in the Midwest. Looks like that is not going to stay to our south. That's going to come back in on Friday, so it looks like some more rain on Friday. I got to keep this front nearby. Now, we may dry out a little bit on Saturday, but still there's going to be that threat of some showers. You can see the difference from that front. 80s to our south, 60s to our north. We're right along that battle zone, and that's where the showers will be the next couple of days. We'll start to see those showers each day, I think, at least the threat of them anyway. So today, scattered showers, less of a chance, but still the chance of showers tomorrow. Then on Friday, I think some of that rain comes back in with that low. Now, it's going to be cool, and I think still a little unsettled over the weekend, at least a chance of showers each of those days through the weekend. Saturday and Sunday starts clearing out figures as we go back to work.
I know. Right. What's up with that?
We go sometimes.
Oh, well.
All right, Joe, thank you.
Thank you, Joe.